So, Dr. Imahiyerobo, so I am fascinated with your thoughts on this. This is Black History Month,
yes.
And I was reading an article that we actually shared on the Columbia Surgery page that said that only 6% of all of the United States doctors are Black. You're obviously a Black doctor, and you do phenomenal work in the plastics, and I'm fascinated in hearing what advice you might have to increase the number of Black doctors, and not only increase the number of Black doctors, but sustain the doctors that we have now.
You know, Bruna, I think that that's really an important question that has a lot of depth to it. You know, my thoughts on that are twofold. Number one, I'm a little bit surprised by that number. I would have thought that it was higher. And then number two, that tells me that those in my position need to do somewhat of a better job. I think that in order for us to increase the number of African-American and Black physicians in this country, I think that number one, we need to increase their opportunities. And I think number one, we need to make sure that we're appropriately motivating our youth. You know, I think back as a child, and I think I was always motivated by seeing other successful African-American and Black people, and knowing that they had been able to achieve their success no matter what it was always motivating to me. And so I think it's really important for our youth to see others that have been attaining their goals and living their dreams, doing those things and interacting with our youth, because I think to a child that can mean a lot, and it can give them the drive they need to say, hey, I can also achieve my dreams. And then I think as a society, I think that that tells me that we need to work on the opportunities that we're giving our young African-American and Black people. You know, certainly I think we all know that there's been a lot of progress made in our society. At the same time, I think that it's incumbent upon us, and it is our responsibility to make sure that everyone in this country has the appropriate opportunity to achieve their dreams. And so I think that there are identifiable barriers that can be looked at, and anything that we can do to help someone get past those barriers, I think would be helpful increasing those numbers. Mm-hmm. You know, I think that continuing to celebrate Black History Month is another thing that we can all do, making people aware of the rich history of African Americans in this country, the rich history of those who have immigrated from other nations and from Africa, and the things that they have done to contribute to our society, mm-hmm. I think are all really, really important part of that puzzle. And then I think in sustaining that growth, I think having equal opportunity in the workplace is important. And I think having really strong mentorship is important, because it's not enough for us to just go to medical school and to, you know, get a job as a doctor. But we really want our young Black youth, our talented Black youth and African Americans to be at the forefront of their fields and to become leaders. And to become a leader does take mentorship, I think.